now look. I'm no virgin. But the thought of hustling like never had entered my mind. In fact,
my mind was so very clear of the whole notion, so very unprejudiced, that I was very quickly able to absorb the implications and even manage the fleeting fantasy of a career at it. I mean, I was broke, right? So the prospect of sharing my most intimate self with an aging, desperate, not at all handsome man did not repel me. It excited me. $50, man.
I said and grinned. Okay, so far so good. I had problem with neither the concept nor the act. The problem was with the rules, about most of which I was rather vague. I knew for certain only that you make them pay before, because that's what Jane Fonda had done to Donald Sutherland in Clute.
But really, what self-respecting hustler would have trusted a guy who just spent half an hour complaining about his cash flow? Doesn't everybody know? They don't fuck you unless they pay big bucks, and that you never fall asleep in their arms. The one thing I thought sure about was that I didn't want to be indoors with this guy. So I led him to the park, setting the stage for my own downfall.
I took his money, shoved it in my pocket, and then I let him undress me. Right there under the stars, it was a clear night with a delicious warm breeze. We made out for quite a while. He got me going. He was good with his hands. All that handling of fish, I suppose.
And when he turned me around, I didn't resist. I fantasized it was my Italian doll, Frederico. I was aware enough to force triple latex on the guy, but I got into it and we came at the same time. And in the end, with his wet, rubbery sex still inside me, I dozed off.
I heard a noise and woke up to watch him, fully dressed, digging the $50 out of my jeans pocket. I shouted and I tried to run after him, but I was drowsy and shocked, and he was on a mission. He pushed me back to the ground and he darted into the woods. "Sorry, man, really sorry," he said, and he was gone. Oops.
This is not fabulous. I'm fabulous. This is not fabulous.
This is as low as I could ever think of sinking.
I'm sensitive, you know. I get by happy-go-lucky, full of laughing and smiles.
But I've got my breaking points, believe me. Worse than that, I so hate being bummed out that then I get all freaked out about everything, most of all about the money thing. This Frank McFuck had no right to happen to me at this difficult time. No job, no dad, not a penny in my pocket, some slime on welfare rips me off. At this moment, I can see no other catastrophe to equal my own.
Not the sinking of the Titanic. I made the right. Not the gulags where Stalin buried millions of the politically incorrect. Not the empire building crime. Of the CIA. Not one speck of any global disaster has caused more grief than my plight is causing me. I gather myself off the ground and nude, a little crazed. I run off after him. It's dark. I see nothing, but I smell him. I hear him panting just ahead of me. I scrape against branches. I bleed, I think. I don't care. I want to catch this fucker and get my 50 bucks back. I'm at a clearing. I see him. He sees me too. He's right out of steam. His car is just down there. He knows. Get to it, I'll get to him first.
At least I would have, had it not been for Officer Fuck, who steps out from the shadows to block my way. He's been waiting here all night to bust a fag, and here I am, nude, tailor-made for the arrest. He can't believe his luck.
No, don't, I scream, he'll get away.
You won't get away, he laughs, and he trips me. There I am, while Frank McFuck slips away in his beat-up Chevrolet. I'm furious. I get up slowly. I catch the prick with his dukes down, and I plant him a good one right on his kisser.
It was an amateur punch, and he's a pro. He recovers immediately, grabs me in a military hold, handcuffs me, and hauls me to the station. A sight to be sure, in my birthday suit with some decorative blood here and there for
ornamentation. He kind of roughs me up a little bit, scares me more than hurts me, and then he throws the book at me, importuning, indecent exposure, resisting arrest, assaulting an officer. Fucked.
And who do I call on my one phone call? Oh, who else? Hello, Mara. Hello, Fada. Delighted to hear from you, both of them, to be sure. They proceed to have joint but mild heart attacks right on the phone, scaring the shit out of me because they were serving me notice, you see. If I fucked up and got nailed on a truly major cause and really disgraced them, then they'd go ahead with the big heart attacks and actually die on me. Imagine being a Greek in jail and mourning parents who had died because of you. It'd be unbearable.
From listening to Rick,
tonight, however, there's no thought of dying, only rescuing the wrongly accused son.
They make emergency phone calls and discover the most expensive lawyer on the planet, a real dynamo, a guy who can raise the dead and force waterfalls to fall up instead of down. He just left. He was here at 3 a.m. with the most excellent hairdo, cleanly shaven like from a hotel barber shop, crisply pressed suit, smelling of Chanel for men. He's perfect, and he sees all of life in terms of baseball. He loves the Blue Jays.
So I'm gonna go to bat for you, kid, but you're gonna have to play ball too.
We're getting you pitched out of this bullpen, but at great expense. Your folks are mortgaging their house, okay?
Punching an umpire is no foul ball. It's like a strikeout and getting ejected from the game combined. The judges will set bail at 100, maybe 200,000, you know what I mean? Okay. Once you're on your own, you'll be on your own to make the team.
No fielding in the parks, no bunting in the clubs. They watch the clubs, okay? No brawls, no violence of any kind. No dates at all, except with girls. Get a job and keep it. See a psychiatrist. Don't miss any appointments. If you follow my rules, I'll be able to get you off with a short-term stint at a farm club and a tiny black mark on your record. If you don't, you'll go to serious jail and someone in there will make sure that you never swing your bat again. Comprendo? Oh, yeah. I comprendo. Really, I'll be good. I'll be a saint. I'll have blue balls from here to Mykonos. That's what I'll have. I'll do anything to stay out of jail. Believe me. Ωραία μου ζωή αδικημένη. Ωραίο μου και άπιαστο πουλί. Σαν ένα χέλι στο νερό θα κολυμπάω. Πού θα ξεφτάσω, ποιος το ξέρει. Έλα βρε παιδί να γνωριστούμε. Πάμε σπίτι να ερωτευτούμε. Σαν δύο ψυχές χαμένες να ξαναβρεθούμε. Πού θα ξεφτάσει, ποιος το ξέρει. Just got up. Couldn't sleep all night. But what the fuck, it's gonna be a fabulous day anyway. I just got the word. They've set bail at $250,000 and I'll be out in an hour as soon as Dad sets bail with the bailiff. I'll probably get off on a suspended, but it won't matter much even if I go to a low security for 3-4 months because meanwhile, I'll already be working for the family. Me and Christine will have been on our way to be engaged and all of this thing, these exploits, will be taken care of. I can imagine being held in high esteem with her parents after this exploit with the cop. It shows major Greek testicles to punch a policeman. I'm practically a hero. The fag fin completely submerged. It'll be argued that I was running down a thief who had ripped me off at gunpoint, made me take off all of my clothes so that I couldn't chase him, but I chased him anyway. Not only a hero, but also brave, gutsy, a warrior, a real hero, the way we like a son-in-law. I'll never look for dope with her. I'll never let her tell me what a genius she could have been if her parents had only let her go to that special school out of town when she was 9. But we'll live together happily ever after and leave each other entirely alone. Look, give me a break. I come from a culture where Robbie Williams' sex life is more important than the bombs in Afghanistan. So what do you expect?
Opa, opa!
Opa, opa.
Thank you.